Hey guys, it's me again. So I decided I needed to do a really quick review on one of my most favorite and loved foundation of all time. And it is, if you guys, this is actually not a drugstore foundation, and I apologize because I do have a lot of foundations to review that came from drugstores that I absolutely love as well. But today it isn't about them. It's about this one, and it's the Chanel Pro Lumiere Professional Finish Makeup with SPF 15. You guys probably have all heard me tweet about this as well. It's the 40 in beige, which I absolutely love. Intensity 2.0. I'm not sure if that has anything to do with the coverage. I'm wearing it right now underneath my Studio Fix from MAC. I can't say anything else but good things about this foundation. It has, which, look how messy mine is, I'm sorry. It has, yikes, messy, shame. It has the pump, which is amazing. I absolutely love it. It's very helpful to control. Mine, when I do one pump, I can pretty much apply it with the tips of my fingers, and it warms up really nicely to give you a really pretty easy coverage and application process. And when you apply it with the Sigma, I just washed my brushes so I didn't bring it out, it's still wet. The flat top Sigma foundation brush, which is new with a really thick handle. When I use it with that, I tend to use two pumps, which I feel like, oh yeah, it's a waste of product because this is a fairly expensive foundation, a lot more expensive than the ones that we love from the drugstore. This was kind of like a guilty pleasure type of impulse purchase from Bloomingdale's a while ago, and I do not regret it one bit. And I know the reason why I purchased this because of Lisa D109, I forgot her screen name. I'll put her link right here. She's amazing, absolutely beautiful. She has the Friday, she was my 100th subscriber because I remember I sent her something as a thank you, and she gave me a shout out to one of her videos, which thank you Lisa for doing that. It's Lisa D9 or D1, something like that. I'll put her link right there. And don't forget to watch this video. The little annotation in that corner is from my previous little mini haul. So like I was saying, the reason why I got this foundation is because of her. She always talked about the Pro Lumiere. She always has like the Friday hauls that she does. I know you guys all watch her. I know it. She's amazing. She's so much fun to watch. It says it's a semi-matte flawless coverage makeup. Apply with foundation, brush, or fingertips to blend gently for flawless professional coverage. It does just that. I mean, that's all you need is, you know, your fingertips. If you don't have a flat top foundation brush or the foundation brush, the angled flat ones, your fingertips is pretty much all you need. Like I said, it's got a semi-matte finish and it doesn't make your face oily. I have oily combination skin. I've said this time and time again. It really gives your face a really pretty dewy finish. I can't say anything else. I would really, really recommend this. I know I wouldn't tell you guys to go buy something that obviously I would not recommend at all. Whether or not my opinion matters to you, this foundation is amazing. I'd like to try the other one. It's the matte one. This one is the Pro Lumiere. The other one is the matte Lumiere. But this one is already semi-matte, so I thought it was okay for me anyway. It doesn't make my face oily. I can concentrate a little bit more. If I was in a hurry and I didn't feel like busting out, you know, Benefits Erase Paste or the MAC concealer that I usually use for my under eye area or concealing any other unwanted blemishes on my face. When you're in a hurry, you can definitely apply a little bit on your ring finger and just kind of use it to conceal. Gently apply beneath your eye area where you have, you know, where you have imperfections or dark circles, or you're tired from the few nights before, or just haven't slept recently, or whatever. Highly recommend it. The active ingredients, just in case it matters to you guys, 7.5% octinoxate, and 3% oxybenzone. Interesting. It's a really pretty frosty glass bottle. Chanel logo right there, shiny glossy top. Like I said, the pump is amazing. I mean, what, you know, what else can you not like about it? It's a 12 milliliter bottle, obviously made in France, like it says right there. Not that that really matters, but it's, if you had to buy a really expensive foundation, this is probably one of the choices that I would recommend. NARS is pretty expensive. This one was actually $52, I believe, $52 or $54, somewhere in the 50s, but definitely not more than $60. I know it's fairly expensive. The foundations that we use, the foundation I think is comparable to this actually is the Revlon Photo Ready Foundation, which I absolutely love, which has an amazing pump and an amazing bottle as well. And I'll talk about that in my next foundation video. But I just wanted to share this with you guys because I thought it deserved a little shout out. I hope you guys enjoy that review. Let me know if you guys want me to review any other products that you've seen me use or mention as well. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed that little review. Let me know if you guys have any questions, suggestions on other, you know, high brand or drugstore products that I can try out, foundation wise or not, any beauty products. I'd love to hear that from you guys. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter if you haven't yet, or if you have a Twitter account if you want to. And thank you so much for subscribing and continuing to watch my videos. I appreciate it very much. I'll see you guys later. Bye.